Hi everyone. So today you will be learning a practical session on plastic biology. In this practical, we will determine the phenotype of selected bacterial species based on their resistance to antibiotics. And the outcome from both experiments will offer understanding on the presence of plasmids that carry antibiotic resistant genes in their cells. In the first part of the experiment, we will be using strain from laboratory. For the second part, we will use bacteria isolate from environmental sample. All steps will be demonstrated by Quentin Selma with assistance from Juan Breyer.
So first thing first, we have to clean and wipe our working bench using Dettol solution and the tissue provided. In this session, staff hand has been washed properly to make sure it clean. Next, we have to light up the flame. All work will be done near the flame since it creates the convection current of upwardly moving warm air to reduce the chance of contamination from surrounding air. Be careful when you are working with the flame since the alcohol is easily flammable. Whenever necessary, the mouth of the glass bottle or container are briefly passed through flame 2 or 3 times after opening and closing. Let's start with the first experiment. In experiment A, we will test for the resistance of laboratory bacteria strain towards several antibiotics. We will be working with a number of bacterial strain from E. coli and Pseudomonas species provided by the laboratory staff. We have 3 E. coli isolates, ECO3, ECO4 and ECO5, and 2 Pseudomonas isolate, PA and PS. Next, we have fresh, sterile nutrient agar plates containing antibiotics with different concentration. And here we have 5 different types of antibiotics. We have streptomycin, we have tetracycline, we have carbamazepine, rifampicin, and kanamycin. There are also sterile wood stick in the metal canister for transferring bacteria colonies from the stock culture onto the fresh agar. To start, we have to divide each agar plate into 2 or 3 sectors. Get the plate of fresh agar and do a brief inspection to make sure there are no contamination. Using the waterproof marker, draw lines on the bottom of the plate to create section for the streak of E. coli and Pseudomonas isolate. Be sure to label your agar plate before you begin. On the bottom of each plate, write down the name of isolate, your name or your group number, and today's date. Keep the writing small and close to the edge of the plate. Then, get the metal canister. Inside the canister, there are wood sticks that have been autoclaved and sterilized. Loosen the cap and shake the metal canister to bring the stick closer to the opening. Carefully, uncap the container near the flame to allow small opening and take one stick out using the forceps and immediately recap the container. Hold the stick with your hand on the same side that have been touched by the forceps while keeping it near the flame. Since this stick is made out of wood material and has been autoclaved, no need to flame it. Now, get the plate containing the stock culture while continue holding the stick. Do not put the stick on the bench as to reduce the chance of contamination. Carefully, open the lid of the plate at an angle and continue to shield the plate with the lid. Obtain a loop full of solid culture, which is the pure colony, using the sterile part of the stick. Then, get the fresh plate. Open the lid of the plate at an angle and continue to shield the plate with the lid and make your first streak on the agar surface at the correct sector or section. Be sure to perform this work near the flame and complete the streaking for all plates using different stick for different isolate. Streaking, pick up the single colony using the wood stick from bacterial plates. Then, slightly open the fresh agar plate and do the streak at the correct sector. All work must be done facing the flame. Now, the freshly streaked agar are ready for incubation. Invert the plates and incubate them upside down in the oven at 37 degrees Celsius for overnight. We have done with the first experiment. Now, let's move on to the second one, experiment B. In this experiment, we will test for the resistance of bacteria towards several antibiotics, but using the environmental isolates instead of lab strains. Bacteria are basically present everywhere in our surrounding. By taking environmental sample like water, sediment, or soil, we can isolate bacteria and test whether those bacteria exhibit the antibiotic resistance or not. The sample will be obtained on the day of the practical to ensure that it is fresh. Spatula and glass bottle are provided to the student to perform the sample collection. As for now, we will use a liquid sample that was collected recently by the lab staff. A suitable diluent is provided to dilute the sample, and here we use 0.85% sterile and ACL solution. Sterile funnel and filter paper are being prepared as well to filter all unnecessary debris that might interfere with bacterial growth on the plate. In this experiment, we will do spread plates using spreader instead of using streaking methods. Again, fresh sterile agar plates are also pre-prepared, and here we have an agar containing antibiotic, which are ampicillin, tetracycline, and kanamycin. First, we have to dilute our sample using an ACL as the diluent. The sample must be pre-weighed or measured prior to the dilution. If you are using solid or semi-solid sample, use only 1 gram. If you have liquid sample, get 1 ml of your sample. Here, we use liquid sample taken from Alo Ilmu. Take the volume of 1 ml using micropipette and put it in the glass bottle. Then, add 9 ml of NaCl solution, this is our diluent, to the sample in the glass bottle and shake hard to dissolve it. To make sure that your sample is properly mixed, we can use vortex. Next, we need to sieve or filter the sample mixture. Get the clean glass bottle, sterile filter funnel, and filter paper to do the filtration. In case there are solid floating, you may need to centrifuge your sample briefly to bring down all the debris. The filtration process will take some time, depending on your sample, before it can pass through the filter paper and settle as filtrate at the bottom of the glass bottle. And remember, you have to filter the sample twice to remove contaminants. Now, do the second filtration. Get the second filtrate. The filtrate will have to undergo serial dilution. In this experiment, we dilute the sample to the dilution of 10 to the power minus 2, power of minus 4, and power of minus 6, up to the total volume of 1000 microliter. Dilution is done in the sterile microcentrifuge tube, or sometimes people call it a Pandorf tube. Be sure to label all dilution bottles, tube, and plates with the appropriate dilution factor before you begin the dilution. Take out the sterile microcentrifuge tube using forceps. Do the labeling. And start performing the dilution. So, to perform the dilution, we need to put the diluent first, which is the sterile and ACL. Take the diluent. And put it in the microcentrifuge tube. Next, put your filtrate or your sample into the microcentrifuge tube. To make it the total up to 1000 microliter. Make sure your diluent and your sample are properly mixed by vortexing the tube. You have to do this in between the dilution. Get the fresh plate. Make sure you have labeled this plate accordingly. We will plate the diluted sample from 10-2 dilution and 10-6 dilution. We will take 0.1 ml of sample from dilution tube and grow it on the fresh agar surface via spreading methods. To do the spread plate, take the aliquot of 0.1 ml of your dilution and put it on the agar. Once we put the liquid, we use a sterile glass spreader to spread the liquid in a thin film. If you remember about aseptic technique, we have to sterilize the spreader. In order to do that, dip it into the ethanol-filled glass container, hold it for a while to allow the excess alcohol to drip back into container. Then, flame it briefly to ignite the spreader to sterilize it. Allow the spreader to cool down for a while. And next, we will use it to spread the liquid. To do the spread plate, open the lid of the plate at an angle and continue to shield it. While holding the spreader, rotate the plate on your bench to spread the liquid. Make sure the liquid are evenly spread into a thin film. To reduce the time, you may find it easier to work in pair, like one friend is doing the aliquot, another one is doing the spreading. Unless like Puan Zaima, she's already a professional. The freshly spread agar are ready for incubation. Invert the plates and incubate them upside down in the oven at 30 degrees Celsius for overnight.
Okay, that's all for our first lab practical session. If you have any questions, please let me know. Thank you for watching.